Hello, this is Echoing Clock.
I'm Ripper 95, and we're going to go right into Kopaka's level. Kopaka is the Toa of ICE.
And he's a bit of a hard ass.
But cold as ice.
So we just finished talking.
You're willing to sacrifice our love.
Okay, enough of that. Enough!
I said it before, it happens all the time. You're digging for gold, you leave the world behind.
Cutscene!
Oh, okay.
Kopaka, my brother, I have discovered the secret of the Borok's power, and it is also their weakness. Capture the Krana.
I'm chasing a Borok now. He's heading for the Kinney.
There is that much time.
Now, this is
a bitch.
It's a snowboarding-esque thing, because you're riding on a shield, and you've got to, like, avoid some avalanches, but now that it turns around. Now we're racing Mator now, by the way.
Oh, and by the way, there's 200 damn white stones on this. As long as you get, I think, half of them, you're fine. Okay, you know what game I kind of want to let's play? I'm going to bring it in closer to the end of this cycle so we can maybe do like one or two episodes on it.
What?
Lego Racer. Did you ever play that? Did you ever have the misfortune of playing that game?
I believe I did.
Because I was in that phase where if anything said Lego on it, I instantly said I need that game or I need that product. Oh, please, don't act like you ever had that phase.
No, I know that phase. That's why I laughed. I know that feel. Oh, screw you, buddy.
Yeah, it's really hard to collect the light stones in this game.
Well, at least in the missions. Some missions it's easier. Like the Tahu stage, it's kind of just like they're all right there screaming at your face. Except for the three that I missed.
Why are those little symbols at the bottom mean? I mean, I know it's their language, but
I'm not sure. I think it's a count of how many of the Torn we found. Or maybe it's, yeah, I think it's the Torn we found.
Okay.
That we're snowboarding with.
We have to call it from some cold as ice. We have to buy a beautiful rendition of that Foreigner song. Yes, Foreigner.
Toa Kopaka, the Borok has burrowed through that cliff. I fear it's heading for Kokoro.
So apparently Toa Nuva is now, Native American.
Yeah, I think that's what they were trying to convey.
So there's another Borok. I have no idea what color it is. Okay, so I have to use a shield that apparently he has two now.
Oh my god. I remember playing this part too.
Holy crap, this first person is hell.
This is Quake Pro as hell. God, this is working freaking wonders for my astigmatism.
Holy crap.
Okay, I think we just unlocked a secret. Not entirely sure, but I think we did. And if not, we'll try to get to at least 150.
Oh, now it's... So now you have to use your shield to block him off his thing.
To knock him off his block.
Yeah. Like that. Oh look, he has life bar now.
Yeah. And if he reaches the bottom of the mountain, you lose. Trust me, I've learned this over the years.
So he kind of flies for a bit, so he gives you a little bit of time.
Is that a freaking fish we just passed?
Yeah, I think it was. I wish there was like some sort of speed boost, but oh well.
You can press the up button to speed up. Wait, are we going to beat him to the bottom? I don't He's behind you. Oh, there he is.
Oh crap, no, he burrowed into the ground. Motherfucker.
Oh shit, you gotta hurry up, he's getting close. See that one mountain out there? That's Kokoro.
Sergeant Kokoro?
No, that's Keroro.
Oh, okay.
Oh shit, he's really close now. These are their lanterns. Like, their signals. Oh shit, son. Shit. Shit.
It's okay, I can break these cuffs.
You can't break these cuffs.
Motherfucker.
Oh, fuck, you're dead. Yep, there he is.
Because you burrowed yourself
around. Oh, watch this. Just because he got there.
It's got its own cutscene. And I'm pretty. That's impressive. Oh well.
Like only that house. It's on fire.
Now they're on fire.
How did he light them on fire? I really wish they would elaborate more on which Borok are fighting them, because there's... Every time they introduce an enemy, there's six enemy types, one for each element, mirroring the Toa, so there's an ice one, there's a fire one, there's an air one, there's a whole shebang, but... The ones that are super effective against their own type. The ones that are super effective against another's type are the ones that attack that village. So, for the fact that fire would melt ice, the fire one normally would attack the ice area.
Yeah.
So that's what I'm thinking is attacking them right now. I'm not entirely sure.
Check the screen. What's it look like?
I
want to
say it's a water one. Yeah.
Really. Wait, that's just lock on. I don't know.
No, it's like the little avatar and it's like lock on. So it's the water attacking. Sorry, I kind of dropped the mic there.
So we've got to catch up with this motherfucker. I'm just laying waste to this guy. Oh, he went under me. Crap.
Slow down. Not that much. Oh!
No, it went back like a checkpoint.
Oh, okay.
What is he at? Is he at half-life?
Yeah. I think so.
Shit! Son of a bitch.
By the way, it doesn't reset the Borok, so the Borok's already halfway to your village.
Oh, fuck. Seriously?
Yeah.
Part of me hopes he's just burrowing underground. Damn it! Why can't I make this jump? You do it. Exit jump.
I know, but...
You can't make it either.
No, shut up. We were supposed to alternate 7 times already, but...
Okay. Oh well. My bad.
What the f- No. Okay, I was trying to use the D-pad, but D-pad doesn't really work that well, so... Especially for staring at shit.
There we go.
Oh, shit. I can see him.
There he is. I think he'll go faster if you get more air. Or maybe not. Okay, this mission is pissing me off.
Hey, this is like the one mission that took me the longest on the fucking water level, just because it's a fucking long one. That one water level is probably going to take us 2 or 3 videos, because it's like an hour long level.
Yeah.
Here, you fucking do it, you were doing better.
Okay.
The trick is you want to hit him a lot really early on.
So yeah, this is the water.
Which doesn't make sense, why is he lighting shit on fire? Let's see if you can skip this. Oh, that's right, that's why I hated this. Because the cutscenes are unskippable. Shit.
Yeah. Yeah, like in Jack 1.
Oh god,
Dole Bears.
Shut up, I'm gonna strangle you.
Okay, let's try this one more time.
Oh.
Loading.
God damn this.
At least the loading screens aren't ridiculously long like in Crash Bandicoot 1. Yeah, I mean, not 1, no. Wrath of Cortex. Which is a game we will not be Let's Playing.
Oh, but I love that game.
Crash Bandicoot Wrath of Cortex, bite me, that game sucks. Bite me, that game sucks.
It's the only Crash Bandicoot game I've ever played.
Really? I feel bad for you, then. There are many more Crash Bandicoot games that are much better.
But then again, it is once again one of those games that, like, I had
like a 5-minute loading screen.
Well, I know it had a 5-minute loading screen, but like it was one of those games that I was stuck like a weekend playing nothing but that type of game.
Oh, so
kind of it's kind of like Mother in that sense.
Yeah, the analogy that I heard someone use for why you should play Mother and give it a shot. Basically, if you can't catch up to him once, you're fucked.
Where does he burrow on the ground?
I think right here.
Okay. So I just gotta catch up to him one more time.
Yeah.
Boom!
There you go.
Son of a bitch. I think that's there for that reason.
Yeah. There he is.
Yeah. I need to catch up to him this one last time.
Fun fact, his shield actually has holes in it. Shield actually has holes in it.
Well, it's an energy shield. Son of a bitch. I don't think I'm gonna make it.
Who can make it?
I think we have to kill this guy before we get to this part. That's where I'm leaning towards. Because he's rolled on the ground again. God damn this cutscene. Because we gotta hit him one more goddamn time.
Burning down the house.
Too soon.
Oh, come on. There we go.
The roof.
The roof.
The roof is on fire.
We don't need no water. Let the motherfucker burn.
Oh, well.
Why the hell was closing the door on us? I don't know. Someone who is jealous of our mad scenes.
The mic.
Again. Oh, I just noticed that there's like cool little like rings around the side of the screen when you're in first person. Like you're seeing through this like monocle lens thing. I always thought that Kopaka?
It's Kopaka.
Yeah, Kopaka was like a scientist kind of dude because of his mask.
No, he's got like the max of like I think it's X-ray vision.
Oh yeah, that's right. Because there's no talent that they could think of that would go with ice, so they gave him X-ray vision. And it's really weird that whenever they find one of their brothers or sister's masks in the wild, and they, like, you know, they take it and they absorb that power,
yeah.
It just morphs into their mask.
Yeah.
Like, they don't ever end up, like, with a different kind of mask.
Yeah, they travel too far when they're in the air, that's why.
There's no way you can win this now. Perfect, there we go.
So I know how I'm gonna get the speed that I need.
Try pressing up on the D-pad as well.
I think that might be it.
That's what they said for speed up.
Really?
Yeah,
something that could have been useful to me yesterday?
power up. If you ever read the spell, guy was telling me how to move.
Information that could have been useful to me yesterday?
Who are three people who have never been in my house? I'm sorry, I just love that episode of Cheers.
Damn it!
Have you ever seen that episode? You strike me as someone who would like that episode.
What's Cheers?
It's a show about a bar in Massachusetts. And there's a character named Cliff Clavin, who's just this smart ass and knows everything about everything. And so he manages to get on Jeopardy. And he's just answering questions left and right.
No, it was, he acts like a wise ass, but he really knows nothing.
The only
reason he got all the questions right on Jeopardy, because there were, like, questions like kitchen appliances, mother's boy.
Oh, yeah,
like that.
Yeah, people who live with their mother's kitchen appliances, the U.S. Postal Service.
Yeah, because he was like a postman, but he's like an asshole postman that thought he knew everything.
Yeah, and so he gets like the last question, and it's just this random question about three people.
And
it's like, what are these three people famous for? Like, who are these three people? What do they have in common? And he answers, who are three people who have never been
which presidents were George Washington, Abraham Lincoln, and George Bush? And there was like three people that were never in my kitchen.
No, it wasn't that, no.
It was different presidents, but it was like, which presidents were these? I remember.
No. It was authors. I remember it was like authors or something.
It sounded like that. It's weird how I said, I've never heard of this show, but then, as soon as you know what I'm talking about.
Because my father
was just talking about that the other day.
Yeah, it was so funny. It was just a funny episode. Who are three people who have never been in my kitchen? No, I'm afraid that's not the answer. No, Alex, I guarantee if you call up all three of those people, they will insist they have never been in my kitchen.
Oh, I can hit them twice? Thank you, game.
There we go.
Okay, so first we find the speed boost, then we realize we can hit them twice. Wow, game.
Toa of ICE.
Yeah, we can go to the loading screen.
Girl, and we thank you. Alas, the swarm leader has escaped, fleeing down the mountain. The path down the mountain is most treacherous. There have been many unnatural landscapes there lately. Take care.
I will do my sworn duty.
Fire guy. You can tell by his claws.
Yeah. Oh, Torrin in danger. Danger Will Robinson.
No, you have to turn around.
Yeah, if I cut the rock in half.
Which he actually does in one arc, I think, or one story.
So not only do I have to move fast enough to not get crushed by the boulder, but like it's dropping other pieces of boulder that I have to dodge.
Oh god. Oh god. Oh god.
Fuck.
Oh god. Oh lord. Oh god. Oh, your shield's still there.
It's pointing the wrong way. My energy shield.
God, we are so bad at this game.
Load faster.
You ever have those moments where you really like something before and go back to it and then do it? This isn't as enjoyable as it was before.
I mean, like every day of my life I do something like that. Every time I start a new Let's Play.
So, people who have been eagerly anticipating news about my solo work, who is probably one person maybe, I recently got Doom 1 and Doom 3 to work on my computer. I'm still trying to figure out what I want to do for Doom 2, if I'm going to do Doom 2 and when. Because I think I'm going
to
start with Doom 3 and then go Doom 1 and 2.
I tried to warn you about the boulder,
okay.
But it's too late. The Bo-Rock has fled.
Oh yeah, that's right. This level was long as hell too.
Too damn many light stones. Well, this is really fun.
The rent is too damn high.
The rent is too damn high. Okay, we get it.
I just like that song. It's catchy.
You know what's catchy? My foot up your ass!
No, I don't think so. I think you get hit those guys both times.
Whatever, bitch. Who is that? Another one of these.
Yeah, but I don't think you have to beat it before anything.
Which one is this?
Fire one? Yeah, this is fire one. Yeah, we got smoke coming off.
That would make sense.
Try to hit him twice again. Yeah, it is. Not the spaghetti. I actually recently found out what that's from.
That's from Mario. That's.
It's from Hotel Mario. A Philips CDI game. I only found that out when I was watching ABGN. Oh my god, that's a big game. I thought it was really shitty TV show. But no, it's just one really shitty game.
Son of a bitch. Did I kill it? No. Oh no, so almost killing it. It just calls its buddies. I wonder what happened if I were to kill it. It probably wouldn't call its buddies. Holy shit.
No, it calls its buddies and it kills you. Game over.
Holy shit, that's a lot of guys. So, this is a 21 minute episode. We're gonna be doing like one mission or like half missions per episode later.
Yeah. I was really afraid this was gonna happen because I remember there's only 6 stages, there's one per Toa. Is there a. Oh, no, 7 technically, because we're gonna hit a bonus mission.
Oh, yeah, this is the final mission. Put you on lock. You don't even know what's gonna happen until then. So this game is more or less a retelling of the movie. Well, the movie and the comic book series both.
The comic. Did you ever, like, when you were a kid, did you get the original Bionicle cases where it had, like, you could spin the case and it had on the side, it had, like, see through it and it would, like, show different Toas and stuff? And it, like,
I'm pretty sure I have 2 of those for every character.
Nice.
Like, I don't know if I have them anymore, but I used to have that many.
Oh, I have them.
Because I had the Toa Nuva and the Toa.
And I was such a Bionicle nerd, so I had the Toa, the Toa Nuva, the Bolrock, the Bolrock Kull, the Rakshi, Makuza. I had to have all of them. That's how much of a nerd I was.
Yeah. I don't think I have Makuta, but I have all the other ones.
Yeah. I remember I got 2 because, you remember William? He accidentally got me another one for my birthday one time. I don't think I ever returned
that. Oh, son of a bitch.
Because if you don't have one of those, I'll be sure to give you one of those if I have an extra.
An extra one of which?
Makuta.
That'd be amazing.
Yeah. And you could show yourself assembling it and like do like a time lapse.
Yeah, time lapse of me assembling all of the Toa. Because I still have all of the classic Toa, so if I can find them all. And if I can't find them all.
I have to find all of my instruction booklets so I can because one of the cool things that I introduced in Generation 2 is that you could take them apart after you built them. And you could fuse 3 of them together.
To make like these like super form.
Yeah, and so I did that with the Bolrock. And
never remember how to take them apart, did you?
I remember how to take them apart. Oh, fuck that, I can take them apart like it's nobody's business. It's, wow, deja vu. For some really weird reason, I have a deja vu feeling.
It's because we've done the same mission like
No, I mean times. Me saying that while that was on the screen made me have a deja vu moment. Is every deja vu moment you have your brain just doing a repost?
Yes.
Because I think that's not the case.
Yeah. Sounds like something Keanu Reeves would say.
Because, you mean, other than, I'm a horrible actor. Fun fact, Nick Cage was supposed to be the latest Willy Wonka and Superman.
He said no.
He was supposed. Nick Cage was supposed to be Neo, Superman, Willy Wonka, and Aragorn.
And he just said no to all of that.
Yeah, because of family commitments.
Wow.
I'm kind of glad that he said no to Superman and Neo and Willy Wonka. They were going after getting movies back. But that's fine.
Oh! I hit him! I shielded him! God damn, this is gonna be like a half hour episode of me failing.
Can we upload half hour episodes?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, because I think our chess episode was like 35 minutes or something like that.
Okay, good. Because after we killed this guy, I think it ends the level. Because, yeah, because then you go to Onua.
Yeah.
Onua's a badass. I loved his voice of acting and all. I have to say, yeah, Onua, I think, had the best voice acting in the movie and the game. Kopaka always struck me as, like, the Spock of the group. Like, he always had to do the logical thing. You know?
Yeah. Of course, like, somebody's gonna be watching and be like, who the fuck is Spock?
And if they are, Russell could go all mad Trekkie on their ass.
Yeah. Because nobody in the world is as much of a Trekkie as my father was. And
I'm sure there is.
No, there really
is. I'm pretty sure there is, Russell. If you really look hard enough into the world, you'll find a lot of people.
You'd actually be surprised by how much of a Trekkie my father is.
Did he ever try to genetically engineer a triple?
I think he did once. I'm not gonna lie.
I'd actually like to see someone do that. You know what movie I like and I wish they had made a decent game out of?
What?
War Games.
How would they make a game out of War Games?
I don't know. I would like to play German Nuclear.
Would you like to play Thermonuclear War? No, I would like to play chess. No, I want you to play Thermonuclear War. People are gonna be like, what the hell is War Games?
It's basically a movie Matthew Broderick made other than Ferris Bueller's Day Off.
Yeah, it was like his only other movie?
No, he was in Deck the Halls. And
what the hell's Deck the Halls?
It was a movie he made much later, back in like the 2000s.
Okay. So is this the last part of this mission, please?
Yes, it is, but unfortunately it's also really annoying.
I mean, if we could do it in one clean sweep, like I used to be able to do when I was like a kid, like when I was like 12.
Yeah, this is really hard. I was never honestly this good at this mission. The only one I was really good at was Nuwa's.
Yeah, because then you have to like follow a bird for that part mission.
Yeah, you had to follow a bird. Because that's how he actually learns how to fly in the book, like a bird teaches him.
Yeah.
Because he honestly thinks that he fell on his head or something. Like, everybody thinks that he really hit his head hard when he landed. And, like, it, like, knocked him out or something. Or just cost him brain cells. Do they even have brains?
Yeah, they do.
Another thing, like, why do they, like, act all, like, embarrassed? Like, if their mask gets knocked off by accident?
It's kind of like the Adam and Eve realizing that they're not wearing a mink leaf.
Oh. Really, a mint leaf? Those really don't cover that much.
Or a fig, or whatever.
What
type of leaf did Adam and Eve wear? It was just like a...
Hey, here's your trivia question for the day. Find out what leaf Adam and... What kind of leaf Adam and Eve wore, and you'll be featured in an episode of Let's Play a Really Shitty Game with Echoing Clock and River 95.
Because I think it might be a fig leaf. But I don't know, I'm not even...
Get it? Oh, you son of a bitch.
I don't even worship Abraham's God.
God, don't even go there. So you don't believe in the binding of Isaac?
Isaac Newton?
No, the binding of Isaac. When Abraham brought his son Isaac up to the top of the mountain because God told him to sacrifice his son Isaac to prove how much he loved God. And then, as soon as he was about to bring the knife down upon Isaac, God sent an angel down to say, no, you've proven that you love God enough, you don't need to sacrifice your son.
Oh, okay.
But Abraham couldn't tell Isaac that that's what he was doing. So
what did he tell him?
Abraham just told Isaac, hey, Isaac, why go to the top of the mountain where all I'm carrying is a knife with me and no one else can hear you scream?
Holy shit. I mean, the only reason I know so much about the Christian religion is because I study religion. as like a side thing. Like when in my free time, I just research other people's religions. Just like, what do you believe in?
Yeah.
It fascinates me. What? I hit my head too hard.
Yeah, concussion. Robot concussion? Robot concussion. Robo-cussion. Why does that sound like a really shitty Netscape?
It probably is a really shitty Netscape. Hit it 3 times.
Ooh. You got a badass over here.
What type of badass plays Bionicles all day?
An awesome badass. And oh, one more hit.
She's probably gonna miss because it just had one more hit. Son of a bitch.
It's okay. It's okay. I'm getting a lot over here.
We're dropping out like spikes now.
Hit him. There you go.
No, he doesn't send out his buddies.
I must return to the
fuck
others.
Fuck you, bitch, with that. Loading.
Jesus Christ, this is a 31-minute episode.
And just be a badass.
Strike a pose.
Strike a pose like a badass. I got all 0 out of 0 McCorn.
Okay, so
autosave.
We're gonna start off the next episode by checking to see if we have unlocked any secrets. But this has been Ripper95 and
Echoing Clock.
Peace.
Bye.